I love Super Smash Bros. It's probably my favorite video game series, and I've been dreaming of Ultimate for what feels like years now, even though it's only been a few months since its announcement. It's almost undoubtedly going to be the best Smash Bros. So far, and I can't wait for it. However, amidst all my eagerness for the game, there's a sentiment that's often repeated in the community that really just bugs me. There's a stigma that people aren't allowed to be disappointed by the Smash Ultimate roster, and if you do dislike newcomers, that makes you entitled and stupid. That just really irks me to no end because I just can't get down with that. But I see these kinds of comments in my videos all the time and all over the place on social media. There's that cartoon image that people always love to post that says, "Let people enjoy things." I like to use that in reverse as well. We should let people also dislike things, excluding, of course, the obvious trolls. For me personally, I've been disappointed with Smash Bros. Newcomers since what feels like forever. But Red, how can you say that when we've had iconic characters like Snake, Cloud, and Sonic? Well, because those aren't some of my favorite characters. That doesn't mean I don't understand the magnitude and impact of them being in the roster. It's freaking huge! And congrats to anyone who wants those characters. I'm truly, truly happy for you, honestly. I'm happy for anyone when their character gets in. But there are people out there like me who haven't gotten to feel what it's like to get a character from their actual want list into Smash Bros. We haven't gotten that catharsis of seeing our character on screen, getting a reveal trailer, being able to move them and play as them in the game we love. But Red, there are over 70 characters in this game. Can't you find someone to play? Yes, of course I can, but that's not the point. We've always found characters to play and that fit our style of fighting, but that's again not the same as having that connection to one of your favorite characters. When I fell in love with Smash Bros., it was because of the gameplay and not necessarily because of the characters on the box. I saw Mario, Pikachu, and others and recognized them, so I bought Smash 64. But what made me fall in love with the series was the gameplay, not the original set of characters we had, the mechanics, the overall feel of the game. I loved it. When I played Smash 64, I didn't even know who Ness or Captain Falcon were. Now over time, as each Smash game has come out, my love for the gameplay has remained, and my desire to play as one of my favorite characters has increased. A list that started as small as just 2 characters and now has grown up to 10 characters that I would really, really from the bottom of my heart desire to play as one of them in the game. And I'm not greedy. I would only need one of them to make me extremely happy and set for life. And with each new Smash game, I would hope that it would finally be my time and that one of my favorites would finally grace the screen. But each time that hasn't worked out. And there are many people out there that feel the same way. Now I'm not saying we necessarily deserve to get our characters into the game. That would be silly. I don't think I deserve anything from Sakurai, and I don't expect Sakurai to be able to please everyone. I've already got this amazing series that allows me to play a variety of different fighters in a style of game that I highly enjoy. But people should still be allowed to be disappointed when they don't get their characters in, and they should be allowed to express that in a calm and healthy manner. I can understand Pac-Man getting into the game. He's a gaming icon. I can understand Ryu getting into the game. He's a fighting game icon. I can even understand Minecraft Steve if he gets into the game. He's been part of one of the most popular video games of the decade. But they don't excite me. I can respect their inclusion. I can understand it. I can even agree with it. But I can't get excited about it. At the end of the day, Smash Bros. Ultimate is still going to be an amazing game. I'm still going to buy it day one. I've already got it pre-ordered. And I'm still going to play it for hundreds, if not thousands, of hours. But if once again, one of my characters doesn't crack the list, there will always be a hint of sadness in my heart that I don't get to have that connection in my favorite video game series. But at the same time, if you're one of those people who say that you're going to boycott the game if characters like Minecraft Steve get in, honestly, that makes you silly too. Be respectful. Express your disappointment calmly. Don't rage at people, and don't spam dislikes on all the videos about characters you don't like. Everyone is entitled to their own opinion. Let's not bash each other for being excited or not being excited about our final roster. That's pretty much it. Feel free to check out some of my previous videos if you have time. Subscribe if you'd be interested in more future content. Thanks for watching. Keep it calm. Keep it respectful. And I'll see you guys next time.